All right, we're doing good. We are about 40 miles from Oklahoma on I-40. We made it through Arizona and then New Mexico and most of the way here through Texas, through Amarillo, up that way through 40. The solar system is kind of an update on that. I know a lot of people had commented that they thought it was going to make a ton of wind noise, that we needed to build some kind of special spoiler for the front to stop. It doesn't make any wind noise at all. It's no difference. There's no noise. There's no whistle. The wind's not ripping them off. They're all completely securely attached. It hasn't slowed down my top end speed. Somebody thought we were going to go 5 miles an hour slower with it up there. Absolutely nothing except for it charges our batteries amazing. We were pulling 30 amps all day, or 70 amps all day today with that. We used the block warmer in the morning, which I needed. The best thing I can do now is set that thing up on a timer. So my block warmer, if I want to be on a road trip, I can just have it automatically kick on like a half hour before we want to leave. I ran it for 40 minutes this morning. It was in the 20s last night where we were at and fired right up. So, you know, 30 minutes is actually probably fine. And that took our batteries down from, they were like 80, I can't remember what we were at. I want to say like 87% after using the batteries all night long, running the diesel fired heater. And we cooked dinner and I don't remember what, you know, the refrigerator running all night and that kind of stuff, charging phones and all that kind of stuff. And then once the block warmer got plugged in for that 40 minutes, it did bring the batteries down to, took a screenshot, I can't recall what it was. I want to say 69%, I think is what it was. And that was 40 minutes of that block warmer being on, which was pulling about 2000 amps almost the whole time it was on, or not 2000 watts, I'm sorry. So it was a big load on there. But it did great. And normally we'd have to start, you know, get up and fire up the generator, do all that, and kill it. You know, we cooked breakfast, everything that we normally would do. And then before lunchtime, the batteries were back up to 100%, just from the solar. And that did everything. I didn't have the alternator hooked into it or anything. It was just solar power. And we were actually pulling amps in, a few minutes before sunrise. Just the sky. I don't know how that works, but we were. And then within an hour, we were up to like 100 watts, I think it was. And then right after that, then the sun was high enough where it just went crazy and charged everything really good. So no noise. The solar panels were securely attached. Didn't slow us down any. There's no downside. It was just perfect. And they're actually growing on me up there. I'm probably going to add a few more, actually. I really like having the power for them. And that was just a really neat way for us to be able to live in the bus without worrying about the generator running all the time. We used to have to start the generator for every single meal to turn the block warmer on, all that kind of stuff. And now we just don't have to and don't have to worry about it. I love the system. I can't wait to get it hooked up to 24 volt and then be able to use, because right now that's only half of our solar power that's being utilized right now. Couple other things. Last night, you know, I was driving through the mountains. That road that we took from Gilbert and Phoenix area up to I-40 was very hilly, mountainy. I was up to 8,000 feet, lots of steep grades. It wasn't a really fun road to drive, and especially the last couple hours of it, I was on it at night. And I had Kelly type in to stay at a Walmart. And so she found a Walmart, and I forgot, I put it in the community tab, the name of the town. We went there, and some guy had a yard sale, and it looked like a permanent yard sale set up in his yard. And he had, on Google Maps, he had Walmart listed as his address or his name for his business there. And that sucked because there was no Walmart in that town. I could have went to a different town. It wouldn't have been out of our way at all. I would have just had to take a different route. So I was so tired and just got on the interstate there. And then the first three rest stops in a row were closed, and they didn't ever say like next rest area closed or anything like that. That was very frustrating to have three in a row closed. I thought that was, you know, they need to have better highway planning for that. Work on one at a time, or, you know, every other one, but not three in a row. So we ended up staying at a truck stop, and then a truck with a refrigerator truck parked with the refrigerator thing right next to our bedroom. So it was so loud with that refrigerator turning on and off all night. We really did not get much sleep. We were up before sunset. We hit the road a little bit before sunrise, hit the road before sunrise actually. And then got quite a few miles. How many miles did we go today? Do you remember?
I don't know.
You can figure it out. So like I said, we're about 40 miles from the Oklahoma border right now. So we're really close to Oklahoma, but, yeah, we're doing good. Everything's great. And, hope you enjoyed the driving video. There's some really nice scenic views, I think, from the video coming up next. Thank you.
great coming up. It's pretty through here. how we passed under the other side of the road. You think it would have put us on that side?
Thank you.
that we got down, we're going right back up again.
Yeah, we came down about 1,500 feet. back here about 45.
47.
Just pick up a little bit of the hills almost done. Come back up there.
Thank you.
Yeah.